Trent, to speak of pro-choice and Catholic in the same sentence is a pretty, I would say, modern phenomenon. And not too many generations ago, those would be unthinkable to put together in reality or in grammar. What happened to adult Catholics such that the catechesis is at such a level where people think they can somehow put themselves into a state of self-hypnosis, vote a pro-choice, or think that way and try to see the world through pro-choice lenses? What happened to the state of catechesis to get to this point?
Well, I think what we've seen happen is that the moral gravity of abortion has been lost in the past 30 years, so that people consider abortion to be a bad thing or a distasteful thing or something they may not like. Mm-hmm. So they consider it something they dislike as opposed to something being objectively wrong. You would never say for other objectively wrong things like rape, I don't really like rape. I would never rape someone, but I don't want to take away someone else's choice to do that. Because we recognize that the wrongness of rape is not a preference claim. It's an objective claim. Mm-hmm. That thing is just wrong because the kind of thing it is a wrong. With abortion, people treat it as, well, if you don't like abortion, then don't have it. I, as a Catholic, don't like it because my church teaches that. But I'm not going to force my Catholic views on others. And I think if you remember, several months back during the election, when Vice President Biden debated Paul Ryan, this question came up about faith and abortion. And Biden's answer was the typical Catholic answer is, I don't like it, but I'm not going to put my faith on others.
Yeah, he even says that it's taught de fide, that life begins at conception.
Right. And it's
wow.
It's a strange disconnect that he says, I believe the unborn are valuable human beings, but it's okay for other people to end the lives of these children because they don't think what I think. Mm-hmm. So it's a massive disconnect when you treat abortion as just a personal preference or a purely religious truth instead of an objective human rights issue.
Abortion and opposition thereto is just a Catholic thing, true or false?
Oh, certainly not. Opposition to abortion can be found in all spectrums. There's a great pro-life group called Secular Pro-Life. And there are pro-life atheists. Nat Hentoff is a great example. He is a atheist civil libertarian, and he actually used to write for the Village Voice, which is the most liberal newspaper in New York you can come across.
Yep.
But he became pro-life, and he's a consistent pro-lifer. He opposes war and the death penalty. But when his colleagues found out he was pro-life, they blacklisted him because that's just, if you are a liberal person, that's just what you're supposed to believe. But he followed the intellectual evidence where it led, and he's now an outspoken pro-life advocate.
And a pariah of the left.
Many on the left who embrace a pro-life view do find themselves outed because it's almost a de fide doctrine of those who subscribe to that political view.
Yeah, and extending that metaphor, they are certified heretics.
Right.
Departing from the orthodoxy.
You get excommunicated if you belong to the liberal persuasion, especially if you're a registered Democrat, because the unlimited right to abortion is an official part of the Democratic platform. If you oppose that, I think it's very hard to be someone who opposes legal abortion and to be a member of that party.
And Trent, you could make it even more PC. We talked about this a little bit off the air. I would never support polluting the environment, but I wouldn't oppose your right to drill in someone else's backyard and create oil spills everywhere.
Right.
I am personally opposed to killing baby seals. But really, if you have access to a baseball bat, I'm not going to stop you.
Right. We have to treat that the wrongness of abortion lies in its objective nature, that it is a wrong that hurts an innocent person and deprives them of the right to life. Just the same as we oppose other objective wrongs like sex trafficking or even things like pollution, that these, it's not just a matter of a personal preference. They're wrong whether you think it's wrong or not. And the reasons we give, while our faith motivates us to oppose abortion, my faith motivates me to oppose rape and racial segregation. But the wrongness of those things can be accessed by reason. They're not merely a matter of faith.
As Christopher Kaiser says in his book, The Ethics of Abortion, with no reference to religious dogma whatsoever. So this is obviously not a sectarian Catholic, Protestant, Christian thing whatsoever. Now,